Dear all, welcome to this new tutorial dedicated to Sass, an outstanding CSS extension that eases the creation and management of long and complex CSS codes attached to your HTML document. In just 11 minutes, we're going to see everything you need to know to start coding with it. Sass stands for Syntactically Awesome Style Sheets, and it's a very powerful language to realize complex CSS files in no time. To follow this video, a basic knowledge on HTML and CSS coding is mandatory. Make sure to catch our HTML tutorial to recover these basics. Let's start with a simple HTML document. To code with Sass, you can use any textual editor, such as the free Notepad++. Just create a new file and define the first variables by typing $, the variable name, colon, and then the correct value, ending the statement with semicolon. At the bottom, let's pick the body tag, such as the entire text of your HTML document, and set its properties within braces, such as the font color equal to the $ mycolor variable, and the font size to the $my font size variable, 22 pixels. The properties syntax does not change between Sass and CSS. Once your Sass code is ready, save it in a SCSS file. This won't be ready to use since browsers are not able to read Sass codes. You first need to convert the Sass code into a CSS file by using a transpiler. The official Sass page suggests several transpilers you can use on Windows, macOS, and Linux, with also the option to install Sass on the command line, although we do not recommend this for beginners. In this video, we will use the free and simple Scout app. After installing Scout app, specify the project HTML folder, the input folder, where your SCSS files are located, and the output folder, where the resulted CSS files are saved. It is very useful to have the project and the output folder the same in order not to use relative paths as you code with Sass. As you click on the play button on the left, Scout app converts your Sass codes into CSS files, in this case a single one. You can also leave the application free running to get your CSS files always updated until you stop the process. The resulted CSS file applies the properties defined in the Sass code. You just need to attach it to your HTML document within the head tag by adding the standard link tag with the CSS file name as href attribute, without relative paths, since it is located within the HTML project folder, stylesheet as rel attribute, and text/CSS as type attribute. So, here is the result. In the second example, we assign to the body tag Lucida console as font family, 18 pixels as font size, and red as font color according to the variables defined above. For the paragraph P tag, we apply bold text with $ font weight and another font color, this time defined with its hexadecimal code. Then transpile the code to update the attached CSS file and check the result. Scout app shows several formats for the resulted CSS file. For example, you can select compressed to get the most compact CSS code or choose nested to get the most comprehensive code instead. The format changes, but not the final result on the HTML appearance. You can also assign properties to specific ID selectors. Type hashtag, the ID selector name special, and all its properties under braces, such as the font color equal to the $ third color value. Save the Sass code. Transpile it, and then add this ID selector to any paragraph with ID, equal sign, and special under quotation marks. You will get the new color on such paragraph as you refresh the browser. You can also define properties inside other properties. For example, let's take the body text with body, and then its properties under braces. Instead of using font family and font size, you can type font, colon, and then set family size within braces. You can also define properties for entire classes. Just type dot, the class name, main title, and then its properties under braces. In this case, the $ third color variable as font color. If you save the Sass code, transpile it, and associate this new class to an H1 heading tag with class equals and main title under quotation marks. This title assumes the class colors as defined. The directives are one of the most powerful features inside Sass. These are indeed functions with or without input parameters that realize operations when they get called within the code. In this video, we're going to see some useful ones, so make sure to visit our dedicated link in the video description for a more comprehensive list of the available Sass directives. Let's create a main P class with its properties and then another secondary P class with a centered text alignment. If you also add addExtend with the main P class name, you import all the main P class properties into the second class, without repeating the statements. As you save and transpile, you get the two classes identical except for the centered alignment of the secondary P class at the bottom side of the page. Another useful directive is the @mixin. Type @mixin followed by a proper name, my format, and several properties under braces. As you define again the main P class, you can add @include and then my format to call the function above, in order to import its saved set of properties. With another directive called @import, you can import the content of a SCSS file into another. For example, if you set a red font color to the H1 tag and save the Sass code as ex2.scss, you can import its content in another code with @import and the ex2 file name without any extension and within quotation marks. The simple name is sufficient since both Sass codes are located within the same input folder. When you save and transpile multiple SCSS files, Scout App generates a CSS file for each of these. Although you just need the main CSS file that you have attached to your HTML document. In this example, you get the red heading title from the ex2 Sass file and the blue body tag from the main Sass code. These directives can also admit input parameters. For example, you can type @mixin txt-set as name, and two parameters within parentheses, called $val1 and $val2 separated by commas. So when you call the directive with @include, you must also specify the values to assign in the same order within parentheses. So red for $val1 color, and center for the $val2 text alignment. Keep in mind that the special hashtag character in Sass realizing a string interpolation. Instead of assigning values to variables, you can store CSS properties to them, using hashtag and the variable name within braces when calling the CSS property. The @if directives are very useful when you want to run a set of statements only in case a specific condition is true. With the input parameter $val above, type @if, the variable name, $val, double equal sign, to say equal, and the value to verify, soft, followed by the statements to run under braces, if $val is indeed soft. You can also continue with @elseif to specify another condition such as $val equal to dark, with another set of statements under braces. You can also verify if $val is different than dark with != equals. Finally, you add an @else directive without conditions to apply other properties in case none of the conditions above is true. At this point, define the text class to fix a font size of 18 pixels and the font color from the @mixin function, depending on the value assigned to the input parameter $val. The @for directive is very useful to realize a for cycle, such as a repetitive cycle running a list of statements for a fixed number of times defined in advance. For example, let's consider this HTML document with four text lines. In a new SCSS file, type @for and then a $i variable that is used as counter, such as a numerical value that starts from 1 and gets incremented at each cycle up to 6. Then define all the statements within braces. In this case, creating a new class named line, dash, and then a number taken from the counter through the hashtag symbol. Each new class also gets a font size at 10 pixels multiplied by the counter value at each cycle. You can also run other basic math operations with plus, dash, and slash. The result of this cycle is a CSS file with 5 classes, each with its font size incrementing. The cycle stops when the counter reaches 6, so you get 5 classes in total. There are also other useful cycles in Sass. Make sure to open our video description to learn more. These are the basics you need to start with Sass. In the video description, you can also download this simple Sass code that shows how this language can be very powerful in respect to standard CSS files. A @mixin directive named colors runs an @if that assigns a different background and text color depending on the $ template variable value between dark and bright. This way, you can easily generate 2 different CSS files, one using bright colors and another using dark ones for the whole HTML page. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial. Visit our YouTube channel and our website to get more free and outstanding tips on other coding languages and programming.